Good morning, everyone. I'm a math teacher. Today I'm going to teach you a topic matrix for the second few students. This is the first part of the mathematics textbook and chapter third. So I'm going to start with the matrix chapter. So first I will start with the matrix definition. So please listen to me carefully. Matrix. A matrix is an order rectangular array of a number or the function. The number or the function are called the elements or the entries of the matrix, right? So first you see this rectangular sign is a matrix sign, right? In this one you can see over here A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33 are the elements of this matrix, and this is called 3x3 matrix. Why? Because there is a 3 rows and 3 columns. Whatever is in a horizontal line is a rows, and whatever in a vertical line is called the column. Okay, so a matrix, I'm repeating again, a matrix is an order rectangular array of a number or the function. The number or the function are called the elements or the entries of the matrix. The horizontal line of elements are set to continue constitute rows, and the vertical lines are said to be the columns. You can see over here, this rectangle sign is known as a matrix, and in this one A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33 are the elements of the matrix. This is called the 3x3 matrix because we have a 3 rows and the 3 columns. Understood, everyone? Now I'm going to start with the types of the matrix. You can see over here, types of the matrix. First matrix is a column matrix. A matrix is said to be a column matrix if it has only one column. You can see over here, the value is given in a one column only, right? So if the elements is given in a one column, so this is called the column matrix. You can see this is the example. A equals to, inside the matrix is 0, root 3, minus 1, 4, or you can write capital A equals to A11, A1, A21, and A31. This is also called as a column matrix. Okay, so this matrix is said to be the column matrix if it has only one column. Okay, so the elements is given in a column form, which is known as a column matrix. Now move on the row matrix. What is row matrix? See, a matrix is said to be a row matrix if it has only one row. That means all elements is given in a one row only, right? This is known as a row matrix. You can see capital B equals to, in the matrix is given root 5, 3, 2, 6. This is a row matrix. Or you can write B equals to A11, A12, A13. This is also known as a row matrix. So you understood, everyone, what is row matrix? A matrix is said to be the row matrix if it has only one row. Now move on the square matrix. What is a square matrix? This is most important topic for our exam. So square matrix, a matrix in which the number of rows are equal to the number of columns is said to be the square matrix. Means whatever the rows and whatever the column, it should be equal in the matrix. That is known as a square matrix. Okay, example A equals to, we have, this is the example, we have root 3, 0, 2, 4, 3, 1, 1, 6, 5. This is 3x3 matrix. Means it should be the, this value should be similar, row and the column both should be equal, is known as a square matrix. Okay, so here, or if you can also write like this, A11, A12, A21 and A22. This is also known as a square matrix. This is 2x2 matrix because we have same row and the same column. So it is clear what is a square matrix. Now move on the diagonal matrix. What is a diagonal matrix? You can see here, a square matrix capital B equals to, in a bracket we have B small b I j out of there m into m, is said to be a diagonal matrix if all its non-diagonal elements are zero. Means whatever the diagonal matrix means, we have diagonally value is given in the matrix and rest of the value is zero. Okay, so you can see over here this value is given, and in this 3x3 matrix also the value is given here. So these value, only diagonal value is given here, rest of the value is zero. All right, so what is the diagonal matrix? I am repeating again, please listen to me carefully. A square matrix B ijk ij m into m is said to be a diagonal matrix if all its non-diagonal elements are zero. All right, so this is example. B equals to, in a matrix form we have given -1 0 0 2, so these diagonal values given and rest of the value is zero is known as a diagonal matrix. All right, now move on the next topic, next definition, which is scalar matrix. Scalar matrix, what is a scalar matrix? A diagonal matrix is said to be a scalar matrix if its diagonal elements are equal. Means the diagonal value is always equal, it known as a scalar matrix. Okay, we can see over here these values are similar, these value is also the similar. So what is a scalar matrix? A diagonal matrix is said to be a scalar matrix if its diagonal elements are equal. You can see was the example B equals to, in a matrix form we have 1 0 0 1, and the diagonal value is given 1 0 0 1, so the diagonal value is given here equal, so this is known as a scalar matrix. You can see over here also, see we have root 3 root 3 root 3 diagonal form, that means this is a diagonal matrix. Now move on the next definition, which is identity matrix. Identity, you know about the, what is identity? Identity means one. So what's the definition of the identity matrix? A square matrix in which elements in a diagonal are all one and rest are all zero. See the example A equals to 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1, means the diagonal value is always one and rest of the value is zero, so this is known as a identity matrix. Got it? Now move on the zero matrix. You can know the zero matrix means everything should be zero in the matrix, is known as a zero matrix. The definition of zero matrix is, a matrix is said to be a zero matrix or the null matrix. Null matrix or the zero matrix means same as matrix is said to be a zero matrix or the null matrix. The meaning, you can see the example here, A equals to, in the matrix we have all elements zero. See, in 2x2 matrix also we have the all elements is zero. Alright, this is 2x2 matrix, this is 3x3 matrix. Everything is zero is known as a zero matrix. Okay,